everyone. My name's Brian, and I used all these old fence pickets to make a big old wooden sign for a coffee shop, locally. It was a commission, custom made, by hand. These fence pickets were nice, but they had to go through a planer first to even them out and make them smoother. After that, cut them all, ripped them. I ripped them, that's the term. Ripped them on the table saw. Yes, I know my fingers are pretty close. They're too close. I've got a new table saw now. Won't happen again. Glued them all together. Now that the width was exactly right, because this thing had to fit in a window. Clamped them. I need more clamps. Weighted them down. And glued it all up. Here's the part where I sanded for about 3.5 hours. It was not interesting or fun, but it had to be done. And there was supposed to be text on both sides, painted on both sides of the sign, so I didn't really have the luxury of bracing them all across the back like I wanted to. I just put a thin, unobstructive brace on either end. Stain! Time to stain! Client wanted a pretty dark stain. You'll notice I'm not wearing gloves. There's a way to get stain poisoning through your fingertips. It's gonna happen to me. All worth it, though. Look at that. Oh, that looks nice. Oh my gosh! Look at the grain. That's very nice. That turned out well. Put in the text that the client wanted with, you know, the font type. Fired up the projector. And totally cheated! This is how I get text on a sign, especially when it's large text. White colored pencil to trace the outline on a dark background. Worked very well. For large letters. Anyway, kind of tedious when it's small text, but this was not small text. Very straightforward. So that's what you get when you're ready to paint. There's the outline, very clear. The paint I used was UV-resistant exterior house paint. This thing would be hanging in a window, exposed to the sun at least part of the day, so a little pricier for that type of robust paint, but thought we'd better be safe than sorry. Didn't want it to weather prematurely. This is more painful than it looks. My arm hurt, my back hurt, my shoulder hurt. Used a straight edge foam brush for the straight letters on this side. Worked well, saved time. And smaller brush for their logo. It's a coffee shop and post office, which works very well. Then I had sink these things, these long, I think they were 5-inch black screw bolt things and the eye hooks to hang it in the window in the shop, which was the most terrifying part of the entire process. I had to drill holes through the top of this thing as deep as I could and then torque those bolts down into it because I didn't want this thing falling apart. Once it was hanging by the eye hooks in the very top board of the sign. Structural integrity. That's what it looked like with the bolts in and the eye hooks ready. This is on site. That's the window. It's about 17 or 18 inches tall. I forget. By 6 feet wide. And it fit! I was terrified that I'd get there and it wouldn't fit. Measure once, twice, three times. Measure a dozen times to make sure, kids. And it'll fit like it should. Oh, it looks good. There it is over the gumball machine. I like the gumball machine. I like the sign, too. I don't know if that address number is still in the way on the outside. Oh, well. Shop name is now visible from the outside. It was not before. Turned out well. I like it. Thanks so much for watching. I appreciate it. If you enjoyed it, remember I'm on Instagram and Facebook. Other sign buildings, paintings, general artistic shenanigans. Take a look. Peace and long life.